This week, our chart-busting Fab Five girl group head down under to find new fans.
Back, are you?
Do not film me now!
They've got just 10 days to win over the Aussies on a whistle-stop promotional tour.
Up until now, they haven't really gone anywhere else.
But it's also a chance for Girls Aloud to let their hair down and get into holiday mood.
You see the size of my case, I just didn't know what to bring. Half of it's going out.
Halfway across the world and away from those pesky paps, the girls do what girls do best.
I don't think we'll miss being mobbed, no, or recognised.
We're off to the club.
I'm not happy.
And a girls' only holiday wouldn't be the same without a few problems.
Who looks like the dickhead? Not you.
A holiday romance.
I've fancied him for ages and he's a babe.
And a chance to get busy with the locals.
Can we meet the girls, please?
We're going to meet them.
Do you know what they're doing tonight?
I think everybody deep down is a huge Girls Aloud fan.
The Girls Aloud management want the five popsters to conquer the world one continent at a time, and they're starting with Australia.
The international markets can be bombarded with facts and figures of charts and sales history, etc., etc. They can watch fantastic videos, but the most important thing for them is actually to meet the artists themselves and form a relationship.
It's really important that we break into more markets because it just means more money.
If we break Australia, it's a good way of trying to break Asia as well.
Australia is a hugely important market for us. First, from a financial point of view, it's the sixth largest market in the world. From an artist point of view, it's an amazing market for receiving new music and also is very important getting our foothold in Southeast Asia.
Hillary gathers the girls together the day before their 18-hour flight to go through their grueling schedule.
Really, I just wanted to go through the schedule so that you kind of have a bit aware of what's going on before we get there. And it is a tough schedule, I'm not going to pretend it's not, because it is.
But Sarah's missing. She's been struck down with a mysterious illness.
I believe she's been better today than she was yesterday. And the hospital don't think it was anything serious, so it must be a really bad flu bout.
As the girls get into holiday mood, head of international marketing at the record label takes the tour very seriously.
There's always a risk when you send any artist into a market. You don't know if it's going to work or not. Particularly when you go to Australia, there's a huge investment in getting the artist there in the first place. That's the risk you take.
It's the furthest any of our girls have travelled, and after almost a day in the air, a weary girl band arrive for the first glimpse of Australia.
Then you won't sleep tonight after dinner.
I will, because I'm going to be taking some more pills tonight. You won't me.
But there's no time for jet lag or sunbathing. The girls have a whole new country to charm into submission.
See you in a bit.
Oh, all right, bye.
Do not film me now.
It's their first morning, and Hillary's biggest concern is makeup. The famous laid-back Aussie attitude is beginning to cause her some problems.
Absolutely ridiculous. We'll turn up, but it is a bit weird. It's 10 minutes to go and they haven't come in to set up. It is a bit weird.
They're coming up. They're just sitting in reception. I did call before, but...
Why are they sitting in reception? We were told 10 o'clock start, so I thought you were going to be here.
I've been downstairs quite a while, actually. They were calling various rooms.
One person called me. Not one person from reception called me.
Really?
Yeah.
The Girls Aloud Roadshow has a team behind them, and organising their every move is Mark Friend, the International Promotions Manager. He knows how important hair and makeup is for the girls.
Hair and makeup is obviously one of my concerns when working with the girl bands. So obviously when they're not bringing their own, so we've used local people. But everyone seems very happy so far, so hopefully that'll set the tone for the trip.
On wardrobe duty is Lauren Jones, the Australian stylist. She's been thrown into the wardrobe chaos and doesn't know what's hit her.
Fat little belt, some shoes, bit of glitter.
She's just wearing this just for a phoner.
Where is that? 10 minutes
late.
Lauren, we're getting dressed from wardrobe.
Lauren, can you bring Nadine out in a minute?
Yep.
Yeah, I've really got to carry on. But if you could take her down to the lobby. With Cheryl, please.
Oh, do you know what I forgot? Your room key.
Oh, are you being serious?
Lauren, please. Where's my shoes?
10 a.m. and the Girls Aloud camp are running late. There's been a wardrobe malfunction and trouble is brewing.
And look at that, I've dressed from wardrobe. The dean's dressed from wardrobe and you told me to put my own clothes on.
The reason that Nicola and Sarah...
I'm like a tramp and them three are all dressed up. Kimberly's not coming because she doesn't feel well.
Nicola and Sarah are doing...
Yeah, I know, but what I'm saying is, as a band...
But you're not doing anything as a band yet.
Cheryl, is that you?
Yes, it is.
Okay, you go down now.
Listen to me. No, all I'm saying is, everybody else is dressed to the nines and I look like a tramp.
You don't look like a tramp, babe.
Well, why did we not all just get dressed from wardrobe?
You can get dressed from wardrobe. I thought you chose to wear that.
No, she said we were all wearing our own clothes.
It was only because Nicola...
Now everybody else is dressed from wardrobe.
At the moment, they want you now to do one TV interview on your own.
TV? Oh, this just gets better.
It's fine. You'll be sitting down. You'll be shot from the waist upwards. You look lovely in that top.
So is Nadine going to go and do a radio dress from wardrobe and I'm going to do a TV dress in my own clothes?
But the reason that the Dean's doing something dressed from wardrobe is because she just had no time and that's why I just...
Had no time? She had the same time as everybody else?
I don't know what else I can do. I was told... Hillary said to me, the girls can dress in casual gear, which is fine.
It doesn't matter. I've already
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
See you later.
She dresses everybody else from the band from wardrobe and lets me come down as my own clothes. And I'm doing a TV. So who looks like the dickhead? Not you, because the other two are dressed as well. And then she's gone. The Dean didn't have any time. I said she had as much time as anybody else.
No. What is wrong with me? I was robbing myself a bag.
I don't even know where we're going, do you?
No. Reception. We'll just go to reception.
With 10 Aussie journalists sat in the lobby, the girls put their wardrobe issues to one side and go on the charm offensive.
See? Hello.
Hi there.
Hello.
So are you guys called to do a quick TV interview now here in the lobby?
Well, together.
Yeah, before we leave. Is that all right?
Are you all right with that? Well, it's just, I don't understand where the logic is. Sorry.
Oh, yeah, to do it together?
Close dramas.
She doesn't like me, so she refuses to speak on camera with me.
I don't think anyone really, from what I can gather, likes you.
Justin!
No, it's horrible, isn't it? Just noticed.
I told you.
Get away!
We can just do that one. If one of you guys wants to do it on your own, it's cool.
Nadine's dressed for success.
Oh, hello, Nadine, you all right?
Good to meet you.
Oh, hi. I'm Cheryl, nice to meet you, all right?
As the first wave of journalists are taken care of, the girls dash off to a sound check. 2 hours late!
Right, what we need to do now is run it quickly, all the way through, because we are so late.
It's their first live performance down under, and the girls are keen to impress.
That's it!
I'll just come in at the corner and see if that's all right.
They've learned from bitter experience not to leave anything to chance.
This place reminds us of another showcase that we did before in Zurich, and that didn't go very well at all.
We changed the choreography ages ago for a certain section of Sound of the Underground, but our lovely record company back home have decided to give us the wrong tape.
So we've got to do the old choreography.
So we've got to do the old choreography, and it is embarrassing, because it's like a jungle step, and we've...
They're all, like, just not suited to this.
Now 3 hours behind schedule, 5 stressed girls race back to the hotel for the second wardrobe fitting of the day. But things go from bad to worse.
So who decided on the red, white and blue?
I can't wear the skirt.
And I can't wear the
skirt. Nadine was given these trousers, which I actually don't mind the trousers. It's just a bit like... I don't just roll me your feet.
Sarah is unimpressed, like, really not happy at all. I think she looks fine. I think she's a bit tight in the corset. She feels like she can't breathe. And the trousers are too big, apparently, so she's a bit scary at the minute. But it'll be fine.
Like, I've got no arse.
Is there another option?
If there was, I'd be wearing it.
Not too...
Unless we change the whole outfits when we're already 10 minutes late,
that's the problem.
Then I don't really know what we can do.
got a wager going on. What? 50 quid, my nipples pop out. On the love machine.
They've done makeup, they're now doing hair, and there's one more to go. There's Sarah to finish off her hair, and then we're out of here. There's nothing else I can do.
God, I just don't understand why it's got to be so stressful all the time.
Crap, crap, and double crap.
Because tomorrow usually we're going to have to start earlier.
An hour later, five impeccably dressed but very grumpy girls arrive at the gig.
Have you seen it out there?
But their mood soon changes when they see how many people turn up.
To let you not believe.
Oh my God!
I think they were just chanting Girls Aloud. I was on the toilet. I was thinking, I hope they are.
Ladies, you ready?
Yeah. One, two, three. Everyone, two, loads three. Of energy.
We're gonna walk on. When you get to your stop for your position,
yeah.
I'll then play the track. After a manic day, all the girls want to do is go back to the hotel, but management have other ideas.
Oh, please, Hillary. We're not meeting press people now, right now, will we?
Yes, we have to.
The girls may not want to meet the press, but outside they've gone down a storm with the natives.
The ginger one!
It's the ginger one. I don't know why.
Fantastic. Amazing performance, really tight.
You're that rude.
I did spot you.
Day one down and the girls go off to their rooms for a supposedly quiet night. But two of the girls have other ideas. Coming up, the girls are in full holiday mood and really let their hair down.
We're off to the club. Taboo.
Cheryl pays the price.
I tried to eat a piece of toast.
Tobacco.
And a famous secret admirer has his eye on Nadine.
I've fancied him for ages and he's a babe.
Our princess is a popper in Australia on the hunt for new fans, and they've got just under a week to win over the natives. The girls leave to go to Sydney on the next leg of the Girls Aloud Charm Offensive. But not everyone's feeling as chirpy as Nicola.
You're ill, I'm good. Well, should have took the sensible option with me. Oh my God.
Cheryl and Nadine spent the night before demolishing the contents of Nadine's minibar, and Cheryl is paying the price.
I've still been drunk. I tried to eat a piece of toast. Oh no.
Tobacco.
Four girls, Cheryl and her hangover, get back on the road to go to the airport.
It's like having a tour bus, isn't it?
Got to go out one night.
Come shop.
That's May finish there. Like, seriously, I'm not born at Olympia. It's really bad. And I advise anybody, if you're thinking about having a drink, not to.
And Cheryl makes friends with a handy receptacle.
I feel part responsible, but I'm not.
I'm holding her 100% responsible.
Like, we had three different cocktails. And then wine.
Cocktails and wine.
Cocktails and wine. And no dinner.
No wonder she's done in then.
At Sydney, the girls are treated to a surprise welcoming committee.
Can I just get a shot of everybody together?
No chance. Are you joking? Looking like this? No chance. I've got spew up me trouser.
The girls' morning starts early with a song and dance on Australia's biggest morning show, Sunrise TV.
I'm really surprised that this many people have turned up.
It's not just the girls up really early, so are a large number of Girls Aloud fans.
Hardcore Girls Aloud fans.
At least they're honest about it.
Can we meet the girls, please? Oh, my God!
Yes!
We're going to meet them. Do you know what they're doing tonight? There we go.
Girls Aloud.
Three, two, one.
It's a great sound, they're good looking. Probably hit huge.
Oh, it's too much.
That was just brilliant.
That was so cool. I'm probably not going to sleep for another 2 days now.
They're hot. Yes. If I was straight.
With the hardcore fans taken care of, it's on to the next round of promotion for our busy popsters.
We're live this Friday afternoon and joined by some of the most stunning women in the entire world. Aww. Please make them welcome. It's Girls Aloud.
Hello. And joining us in the Cubby House this afternoon, five beautiful girls, five very loud girls. They are Girls Aloud.
You guys going to be running amok while you're in Australia?
Well, that's what we're trying to plan. We've got to get away with murder over here. We haven't really done anything yet.
With TV and radio under their belts, Hillary's hectic schedule continues and the girls dash off to the zoo for some photo opportunities.
I just like animals and cages. It's not really bad, so I'm really anti-animals. Like, I just think they're so unpredictable. It's clinging on, you know, like, its paws are clung.
Oh, my God.
What will it do if I kiss it? Bite me face off? Look at her, she is...
When we come in here, guys,
off her head. Wouldn't like it.
No.
Yeah. We're just sitting on this teddy at the moment.
Fucking hell.
Exactly.
Far too close to that.
Can we just get a proposed group shot for this photographer here, right? For Girlfriend Magazine.
Oh,
beautiful.
There are no bigger Girls Aloud fans than Emily and Lang. These two Australian superfans discovered them 3 years ago and have been devoted ever since.
I'm Emily.
Hi, I'm Lang. And we've loved Girls Aloud for about 3 years now, I think it's been.
Yes.
We're completely obsessed with them. We love them all. Kimberly's my favourite.
Nadine's my favourite.
However, we do love them all. I think everybody deep down is a huge Girls Aloud fan.
As a reward for their Girls Aloud commitment, our Aussie superfans have been granted an audience with their idols at Sydney Zoo.
I can't believe we're going to see them!
Yeah. Emily and Lang finally meet the objects of their obsession, and our superfans are a bit shell-shocked.
I keep hanging my chest like you're my...
I just saw my hand shaking in.
It's just surreal. It's the only word there is to explain it. Like, these aren't real people. They're people in our TVs that dance around. But they are real. Bye, Nadine. Bye, Sarah.
Thanks for coming.
They say goodbye to us and they're so beautiful. I just kept kissing them. More kisses.
Back at the hotel, and even a spot of sunbathing isn't wasted as the girls do yet more interviews.
We're doing phoners for radio stations and stuff and interviews.
I've always been at stage school and doing shows and musicals, and then as I got older.
Oh, God, why do you keep giving us these hard questions?
But not all the calls are from the press.
Who's this?
Nadine's been keeping a budding holiday romance secret and she doesn't want this call to be filmed.
I'm good, I'm getting something.
Nadine's famous admirer is from the hit show Desperate Housewives, sexy gardener Jessie Metcalf. Nadine met Jessie in secret in her hotel and now the US star has asked her out for a drink.
I've fancied him for ages and he's a babe.
Keeping your love life under wraps is difficult for any member of Girls Aloud, particularly when it's with a Hollywood actor.
Every interview that I'd done, people were like, are you seeing Jessie Metcalf? Are you seeing Jessie Metcalf? And I'm just thinking, oh, God, no. Because I'm not the type of person that wants to go around and talk about things and say, oh, I'm doing this, or, you know, look, we were here, or we were there.
While Nadine goes off on a hot date, the rest of the girls decide to really let their hair down on their last night.
This is the first night we've actually been out on the town in Sydney since we've been on tour. Aren't you proud of us? Shez has back on the cocktail.
It's not like my Saturday night at home, I tell you.
Us, cameras and drink is not a good combination. Here goes.
But Cheryl's learnt her lesson from last time, and Hillary takes her back to the hotel to get an early night.
I'm too tired, literally falling asleep.
We're off to the club.
A few tequilas later, and the others show no sign of slowing down.
Thank you.
It's 2 a.m. and the others are ready to turn in. But Sarah's determined to go it alone.
Where's Nicola?
The next morning, and Sarah relaxes by the pool, knowing there's no incriminating pap shots from last night.
I like the fact we don't get stares wherever we go, like here. But, you know, in England, I suppose, we are more well-known, and it's nice to get recognition for what you've done because you work so hard for it. But then there are times where you do wish that you could just be invisible.
The night out was a bit of a mad one, but I think it was worth it. We all had a really good time and, you know, we did go a little bit wild, but we were in a new country where nobody knew who we were, so we could get away with murder.
The trip has been a success and the girls discover they've hit the Aussie pop charts.
It's really good that it's gone in at 26, like, the best it could possibly have done.
And Nadine's hit the jackpot.
I don't know if there's a romance with Jesse and Nadine. I just know they met up and had a really nice evening. And I do know that she's got a lovely bouquet of flowers. More than that, my lips are sealed.
Next week, Sarah crashes and burns.
Nice and steady till you're on the circuit.
Nadine shops for saucy underwear.
Do you have just plain white underwear?
No, you don't do that. No. It's more adventurous than that.
Yeah. And someone pays a surprise visit.